square root and cube root. Okay, what is a square root? A square root of a number is nothing but is a number with the square of which of that number is equal to the given number. So it may be confusing for you, but let me explain you with an example. If you have a given number whose square root, it is called a square root of some number, you will get an answer. And this answer, when you multiply with itself, you have to get this given number. That is the concept of square. Okay. So similarly, cube root is nothing but, so here 3 cube root of, cube means 3, 3 cube root of given number is equal to number. That is, again, for this number, if you multiply 3 times, number into number into number, you have to get that given number. So, normally what we'll do is, this is a reverse process of squares, finding squares. So, if a number is given, it is easy to find squares. But if a square is given, it is very difficult to find square. So, we have many shortcuts on this. Let's see. First, let's see the procedure of finding how to find square root. Next, I'll tell you the shortcut. And shortcut is enough for finding square root and cube root. But before going the shortcut, let me tell you what is the procedure. First, write the given number in terms of its prime factors. Okay, so you have to write this given number in terms of only prime factors. And how to write that? If you do division of this given number with the prime numbers and until it gets 1, then product of all those divisors are called as prime factors. Okay? Now, for every pair of prime factor, you copy one prime number into the answer. And finally, product of all prime numbers which you have taken from each pair will give you the square root of that number. Let's see this process, hectic process, with a simple example. Okay? Take 10989 and you are asked, this is a given number, you are asked to find square root of 1089. If you do divide 1089 with 9, it becomes 91 ja 9, 92 ja 18, 911. And 11, if you do it, 11 ja 121. And if you do it 11 with 11, until you get 1. Then, this is a way of dividing this 1089. And take all these prime factors, 9 into 11 into 11 into 1, 9 into 11 into 11. 9 can be written as, with prime number as 3 into 3, 11 into 11. For each pair, copy 1 3. For each pair, copy 1. So now we have 3 into 11, which is equal to 33. This is equal to square root of 1089 is equal to 33. This is a procedure that you have to be followed for finding prime number. Let's apply the same prime factorization method for finding cube root. What we have to do is, first write given number in terms of its prime factors. I told you how to write these prime factors by division method. Next, for every cube of prime number, copy one prime into the answer. And product of all primes from each cube will give you cube root of given number. Okay? Let's take an example of 9261. If you divide it thoroughly, like until you get 1, with all the prime numbers that are available for you, it becomes 937771. Here, we have 3 threes and 7 threes. In this cube, for cube root, we have to copy only one number, that is 3 here, 7 here, it becomes 21. So, cube root of cube, 3 has to be inside this root. This is root. And inside this root, you have to write 3 here, not here, outside. Okay? If you write inside, then it is called a cube root of some number is equal to 21. This is the procedure for finding cube root using prime factorization. Let's observe the squares and cubes. First 10 squares and first 10 cubes. Okay? Based on this observation, we'll create a shortcut of this. So, before going to shortcut, I have to tell you what is this observation. Okay? See here, 1 square is 1, 2 square, I have written up to 10 here. If you observe it carefully, the unit space for 1 is 1, 2 is 4, 9, 6, 1, 4, 9, 6, 5. And it gets in the reverse order now, 6, 9, 4, 1, 1. Like, 5 is in the middle, now 6, 1, 4, 9, 6, 6, 9, 4, 1. So with this, if you reverse like this, it becomes 5 is center, and for 4 square it is 6 square, and 3 square it is 7 square, 2 square it is 8 square, and it becomes 9 square, like this. Okay, what is the observation we can do it for here? So, in the unit space, if we have 5, definitely, in the unit space of square, if you have 5, definitely the square root of unit space is 5. If the unit space of square is 0, definitely the square root of unit space is 0. If unit space is 1, there may be confusion because this gets repeated. 1 is here and 1 is here. So if it is 1, there may be chance that the square root is for 9 and 1. 9 or 1. For 4, it is 2 or 8. For 9, it is 3 or 7. For 6, it is 4 or 6. And easiest way to remember this is, if n digit is 1, n digit of a square is 1. It may be 1 or 9. So if you add this to 1 plus 9, both becomes 10. Similarly here, for 4, it is 2 or 8, 2 plus 8, 10. And it is 9, 3 plus 7, 10. And it is 6, 6 plus 4, 10. Okay, so here also, if it is 5, 5 plus 5, both will be 10. So the rule is here will be 10. Okay, so with the help of this, if n digit is known in a given question, you can easily identify the unit space of square root. So but this condition is not there in cubes. Why? Because for each cube here, we have result here. And for 2 cube it is 8. For each one, the unit space are different. Different. Almost it covered almost 10 digits. 10 digits. So only thing is you have to remember. So for this unit space, what is the cube root? Here we have repetition of 1496 unit space. Here we don't have any such repetition. So what we are doing is, like, if unit space of a cube is 1, then cube root is 1. If unit space is 8, cube root is 2. 7, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, like this. If you observe it properly, only 8 and 2, his combination is 10. 7 and 3, his combination is 10. This has to be remembered. 4 is 4, 5 is 5, 6 is 6. And again, 7 plus 3, 10. 8 plus 2, 10. Again, 9. So 4, 5, 6, 9 are exceptions. Okay, fine. Let's see how we apply this observation in finding square root and cube root. Let's see how to find square root with an example. So, whatever is the given number in where to find square root, first two numbers from unit space and remaining numbers group them as 1. If it is one digit or 2 digit or 3 digit, group them as 1 for finding square root. Okay, so the method is group 2 digits starting from unit space, so this, and remaining as 1 group. Divide them as 2 groups starting from unit space, first two numbers are one group and remaining as another group. So this is one group, this is another group. And separate it like with square root of 1, square root of 40. And this will decide the unit space. This will decide your tens place. Okay, here how do we decide unit space? As 4 is the unit space of the square root, so answer will, probable answers will have 4 is for 2 and 2 is remaining is 8. So you got square root unit space 2 or 8. We have still confusion. It's not exact. Here we get exact answer. So for square root of 1 is nothing but you have to write integer part of the square root. You have to ignore the points. Okay? If you are finding difficulty in finding exact square root, just see where it is lies between. The given number lies between perfect squares. And take the lowest perfect square. Square root of lowest perfect square, that you have copied. If here square root of 1 is nothing but 1. So this will give you 10 space, so copy here, 12 or 18. One number is below 15, one number is above 15. To confirm this 2, in this 2, take, as you know, this is confirmed, take for 15 square, which is equal to 5, it is always fixed at 25, and only this space is 225. And compare given number with this 225. Why we are doing this? Not to confirm whether this one or this one. So, as 144 is less than 225, 12. If some number is here, which is more than this 225, then this is. Okay? This is the way of doing it. First, separate it into two groups. One group will give you unit space, another will give you 10 space. With the help of 10 space, find middle one, that is 15 square or 225 square or 35 square. If from this, compare with given number and decide which number it is. Okay? Let's take another example. Say, 1089. Divide them as two groups, root 10, root 89. Okay, here 9 will give you that the unit space is 3 or 7. Now here root 10 means it comes under 3 point something, so take this integer part 3. 3. Here 33 or 37. In order to confirm this, find 35 square, which is equal to 2125. So 10810 is less than 225, so it is 33. Let's take another example with higher numbers. And let's see how to apply. Group them into two parts, two groups, first pair and remaining. So separate them, it is root 69, root 187. And 9 is telling you that it is either 6, 3 or 7. And 187 lies between, approximation of 187 is nothing but it lies between square root of 169 and 196. So it is will be 13 point something. So take the integer part, that is 13 here. So 13 is giving you that it is 133 or 137. So again, take 135 square. How to find 135? 25, 13 into 14. Okay, 169, 172, 182. So, and this number is more than this 182.25. So, obviously it is 137. The same logic can be applied for high numbers also. Let's see, same example here. Separating into two groups, 229, 259. And here it is 3 or 7. And here it is 459, means it lies between 49 and 64. It is approximately 7 point something. So, take 7 here, 73, 77. Okay, and take the middle one. What is middle one? 75 whole square, which is equal to 7 into 56, 25, and this number is more than this number, so take 77 as well. Let's see same shortcut for cube root. Same shortcut what we have done for square root. As it is cube, you have to take first three digits and left remain. So separate them in two groups. Cube root of 261, cube root of 9. Here we don't have any confusion. This unit digit will decide the unit space exactly. If it is 1, the unit space is 1. So no confusion now. And cube root of 9 is comes under around 2 point something. So take 2. Ignore the points. So the answer is 21. So here, one step we have benefited one step here. No need to compare here. Only two steps are required. Just group them as 3. Two parts. This part decides unit space. This part decides 10 space. That's enough. Let's find out how to apply this shortcut for decimal points. Okay, here 204.49. Okay, so one thing is sure here, this in order to remove this decimal, what you have to do is you can write like this 20449 divided by 100 because two decimals. After decimal, we have to do this, so we have made it as 100. Okay, so do it separately 20449 divided by root 100. Root 100, you know this, it has 10. So only you have thing is you have to find out for 20449. How to find out 20449? Group them as two parts. So divide them as root 49, root 204. Okay, fine. Here root 49 will decide that it is either 3 or 7. Here the square root of 204 is lies between 14 point something. So take only integer part 14. So it is 143, 147. So we have to find 145 square and take reference of this to decide whether it is 143 or 147. It is nothing but 25, 14 into 15, it is 14 into 15. So it is 20449 is less than 210, 225. So it is 143 is the answer. So it is 143 here. As we have divided by 10 here, we have to make it one decimal. It is 14.3 is answer. So what we are taking is we are converting this decimal to normal fraction form and we are taking square root individually. That is the concept for taking for decimal, square root for decimal. Just try to solve this problems with the shortcuts I have given, explained in the video, and post this answers in your comments. Thank you.
Please subscribe to my channel Connecting Minds for more videos and please share.